Your time has come at last, dear reader. While we began this tale long ago, we hope it is yours to finish. But this story is not yours alone. No, it is tied to another. And the journey you take together could change the fate of both our worlds. Shall we begin? They called it the Cinder Knight. What came from those dark, starless skies would change the world of Moss forever. The peace that had settled across the land was broken by an unconquerable nightmare. And that night, the animals nearly met their end. First, they killed the king. A winged creature broke from the shadows and plucked him from his royal bedchamber high atop the tallest tower. Next, the serpent Sarfog and the armies of the Arcane tore up from the underworld. They ravaged the castle in search of that which gave the king power beyond understanding, one of the fabled glass relics. The king's guard fought bravely, but the castle soon pulsed with the Arcane's evil. Every room was gutted, every statue, tapestry, and adornment hexed. But the glass was never found. Even the reclusive sprites set aside their differences on that fated night. They sent a great champion, empowered by their own glass relic, to challenge the serpent and its steel army. Meanwhile, Sir Argus, commander of the King's Guard, led the survivors west through a temple long abandoned by their ancestors and far away from their newly risen enemies. It was an arduous escape. Finally, after passage beneath the impassable mire, they found refuge in a clearing hidden safely in the trees. Argus charged back to join the sprite champion at the mire's edge. Together, they fought back the Arcane and sealed the temple passage that led to the clearing. But the champion was gravely injured. Clutching his glass, he retreated deep into the forest where he drew his last breath. A large tree grew upon him. It stood many years in watchful duty, safeguarding the glass and awaiting its next hero. That hero, albeit an unlikely one, did arrive at a time she'd be needed most. Quill was out adventuring beyond the edge of the clearing. Dusk was creeping in, but she wondered what she might find if she went just a little farther. She was not exactly sure what she roused, but she felt no danger from the being silently peering down at her. Quill had to hurry. The village gates would soon close, and night would follow. Night, her uncle often warned, was when danger was most present. But Quill preferred the stories of the magical creatures that woke to protect the forest. Thank you. Thanks to her new friend, Quill had saved priceless grains from the hourglass. She raced to the door of the cottage she shared with her uncle, hoping once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend. Uncle Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage.
Uncle! Uncle, there's something you have to see! out past the bell again, he scolded. Quill, I've told you countless times.
I know, Quill replied, crestfallen. I didn't mean to worry you, but I found something strange and magical. Quill's hands trembled as she showed him the glass. What is it? She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken. Just west of the clearing, she explained. And as soon as I picked it up, something started helping me. Uncle Argus followed her motion.
A reader. With you, here, right now? Quill, what you found is very powerful and very dangerous,
he said with great concern.
If I could take this burden from you, I would. But this reader has chosen. Even with the moon full and bright, I must go right away.
Quill pressed. Where are you going? I can help. We can help.
No, he snapped. They'll find you and tear you apart. I have to go alone. It is for your own safety and for everyone here in the clearing.
His long, heartfelt hug told her he was heading for danger.
I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass. Promise me, Quill.
I promise, she said reluctantly, wondering where her uncle was going so deep into the night.
Hey, kid! Kid! Wake up! Hey, kid, over here! I know where your uncle went. I can show you. You're twofold now. Very important. Bring that glass and your sidekick, too. We're going to need them. Quill called out. Wait!
Quill had never met a Starthing. In campfire stories, they often meddled in the lives of mortals. And when they appeared, mischief followed. Passage through the eastern gate was strictly forbidden. But despite her promise, Quill knew in her heart that Uncle Argus needed her. demanded answers. Starling, you can't just barge in here with your riddles. Where is he?
What do you know?
The trouble your uncle's heading for is the kind only you and that silent giant up there can get him out of. This way, kid, urged the Starling. And don't forget to tuck your ears in.
Yeah.
Just on the other side is the Mire,
the Starling assured her.
There's a good chance your uncle's still there. Did you hear that?
The Starling seemed anxious.
I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts. I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me.
A whisper echoed through the trees.
Fought like someone who has stolen our champion's power.
A small, yet fantastical band of sprites emerged, surrounding Quill.
I'm Vader, root seer of the Mire, and you have crossed into our domain.
She sized up Quill with a rueful gaze, then turned her attention upward.
I sense you there, too. I have not felt the presence of such a promising reader in some time.
A youthful warrior marched forward.
Rootseer, I'm prepared to honor our great champion's legacy. Rodent, give us our glass.
Quill stepped closer.
Where is my uncle? If you've hurt him...
Silence!
Veda thundered back.
It was Argus who summoned us here, and now I see why. Young one, I'm afraid the trees hum of attack. Your uncle's been taken to the castle of your ancestors.
Quill's knees buckled as Veda continued.
Argus put himself at great risk calling for us. Your uncle once took a solemn oath to protect the glass of your fallen king. He is the only one left who knows where it's been hidden. The Arcane have long sought to wrest that knowledge from him. And you dare to cross into the Mire with our glass? Sarfog will soon burn through this forest looking to tear you and your reader apart. Unless, of course, you find them first. Take these. Weapons made for the mighty champion who died so that your people could live.
Quill felt its otherworldly power course through her.
Find your uncle, Twofold. Before the serpent and its masters break him.
The warrior fumed.
Our glass with her? Rootseer, she's minuscule.
Come now. The reader has chosen its hero. We must let their story unfold.
Veda replied with a frost of finality and vanished into the shadows of the Mire.
Thank you.
Quill's favorite story. How Sir Argus fought beside the Sprite Champion to seal this temple from the Arcane and secured the survival of their kinds. Simply standing in their heroic footsteps felt like a great honor.
Thank you.
Quill felt a swell of pride as she approached the Cavern River. Its guiding banks once led her people to safety after the Cinder Knight. Now, all these years later, she would follow it back. Quill's muscles ached, and her eyes grew heavy. She decided it best to set up camp and rest before journeying on to the castle.
Hey, kid. Good. You're alive.
The starling spoke as it circled the campfire. Quill gasped in shock as the starling unveiled monstrous wings and curled horns. It descended, talons gleaming.
Oh, dear. I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not scared, Quill replied. I just didn't know starlings were feathered.
This starling thing's gotta go, kid. The name's Adurin. No, we aren't feathered. Only me. I'm working on it. Let's just say choosing the wrong friends comes with a price. But you seem like a good friend to have.
Thanks, I think. Quill readied her meal and paused to take in the strange winged creature who now called her friend. As a field of stars bloomed over the sky, their campfire conversations deepened.
He's all I have. If I lose him, I don't know what I'll do.
Confided Quill.
Adurin looked down at his wings.
If I help you find him, can you help me?
If we can,
we will, Starling. I mean, Adurin.
Although Quill was far from the safety and comfort of her nook in the cottage, her exhaustion led her into a deep sleep.
Hey, Ghostface. A lot of folks have been waiting for a reader like you to return. I know I have. I'm going to scout the castle up ahead. Keep her safe, okay? For both our sakes.
Durin was nowhere to be found, but looming high on a distant bluff was the castle, a stark reminder of what mattered most. Quill drew a deep breath and readied herself for the journey ahead.
she'd seen this view before, in a drawing from her uncle's library. Being here made her heart flutter, and then sink. If the story of her family had been different, this would have been her home.
Thank you.
Durin was back.
Hey, kid. You took long enough. I found your uncle, but the Master Sentry's been activated. I'm trying to sort it out. This way. Uncle? Is he okay? He's alive for now. We must act quickly. As long as that Master Sentry is watching, the path to the castle is a dead end. Maybe you two can find a way to shut it down. And I'll, keep watch. Thank you.
Thank you.
clear, kid.
A Durin affirmed.
It should be a straight shot to the castle now. Come on.
Thank you.
To Durin.
We have to get out of here. Down here. It's the only way.
Made a terrible mistake. What is this place? What's that smell?
Durin?
Sorry, Quill. I really am.
All remains still, save for a blazing shadow poised to strike. Quill's insights felt like quicksand sinking in terror at the sight.
The shape lunged, metal crashed,
and Adirin's light went out.
Quill's beating heart drew Sarfog's attention. It was a monster of such harrowing enormity that survival seemed impossible. But then, the reader illuminated a break in the stone. Quill dove, the opening just big enough, and narrowly escaped the snap of Sarfog's fiery jaw. Instinct fueled Quill's desperate flee. The littered limbs of those before her served as haunting reminders that this was where so many before her met their end. Her adrenaline waned. Trembling and anchored by a heavy heart, she slowed, stumbled, and crumpled to the cold ground. Quill had never felt more small and helpless. It would take an army to defeat Sarfog. Then, she felt a gentle touch of warmth and mustered the strength to look up. The reader was still there. Expressionless as always, but unwavering in their loyalty. Quill felt the depth of their connection. The strength that came with being twofold. They had come so far, together.
My friend, I need your help. If we don't face Sarfog now, my uncle will die. And that monster won't stop until you and I are torn apart. Will you stay with me and try?
Quill searched the silent halls.
Uncle? Uncle!
She called, but only her echoes responded.
Is that really you? You have to get out of here if Sarfog finds you.
Uncle, Sarfog is dead. His voice trembled as he spoke.
The glass, the reader, you've bonded. I wanted to keep you safe from all this. It is not a burden you can bear alone.
I'm not alone.
Twofold and strong.
He resigned. We're safe now, she assured him. Let's go home.
No, Quill. You've never been in more danger.
His voice faltered.
The Arcane do not end with Sarfog. The King's glass, hidden here in the castle. You must reclaim it.
Where? We're ready. Promising beginning, indeed. For so long, another has toiled to write an end for us all. But your bond with Quill grows strong. Your fates, yet still unwritten, are now entwined. And that gives us hope. Yes, your journey together is far from over. Rest now.
The dark wood falls before me, with broken bow and blackened leaf. I stand where trees meet with the sky, and in the stillness find you by. When all the paths are overgrown, and evening falls with crimson glow, into the forest I will fly, and in its shadow.